new year. We bless your holy name for the gathering of the women of Yo. Father, even at this time, more than you have been speaking unto them, speak again in a clear voice to every one of us.
Amen.
Thank you for the leadership of the diocese, and particularly for the first woman in this diocese, Mama Bishop, the evangelist Olufumeke Olubowale Niarukoyo. Thank you, dear Father, for the wisdom thereof. Thank you for the leadership, and we are looking unto you for a sincere direction even in this year 2022, particularly in this retreat. May none of our wife return back home empty in Jesus' name.
Amen.
For every one of us, men and women in this diocese, to learn and to know how to avoid the desires of the flesh, grant unto every one of us.
Amen.
Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let me say. Once again, let me say Happy New Year to all our mothers. Like I said, okay. Happy New Year to all our mothers in Jesus' name. And particularly to Mama General. Mama General, God bless you.
Amen.
The Lord bless you.
Amen.
The Lord keep you.
Amen.
The Lord will watch over you in Jesus' name. We want to look at how to avoid the desires of the flesh. And the summary is going to be on three organs of human that always increase the desires of every man. But before we do that, I want to take time to look at the summary of Apostle Paul to the letter we are looking at, Galatians. And looking at the city or the town in our own time of Galatia and the mindset of Apostle Paul. What Paul saw, if Paul is alive to see what Nigeria is today, I am sure he will not just say foolish Galatia. He will have looked at a bigger adjective to qualify the present situation that we are. What Nigeria is. I try as much as possible to make a small note, just one page, thinking that I will have it go round. But the number I see here is more than what I have. So, Mama General, okay? So, I have a 20 something here. So, if my mothers, you can see two, it will go round. Two. Yes. Yes, I was trying to describe the mindset of Apostle Paul for the Galatian people there. And if we look at it from chapter 1, Apostle Paul had a message. And the summary I have for the entire chapter 1 is chapter 1. I will call attention to it. Now is the summary.
Okay.
Right? Galatians chapter 1 verse 8 and 9. Galatians chapter 1, verse 8 and 9. She, are you ready? Some versions say, let it be condemned. And I love what verse 20 equally says. Alright? Which, anytime I have opportunity, I always want people to memorize it. For us to be reminded at all times that sincerely what Apostle Paul saw and he tried to describe it is more than what is put down. And verse 20. Say, if any other one is preaching this, to substantiate that his own is more genuine because it's the word of God. He said, God forbid, I don't lie. Verse 20. That he don't lie. If we look at it today, I wonder how many of us, whether pastor's wife or even pastors on the altar, can say, sincerely go and find out what I am preaching. How I am living, and compare side by side with the Bible. That is the situation that was in Galatia. And today, it's like more than that we have in Nigeria. And looking at chapter 2 and 3, one can summarize it that it's dealing with the justification by faith. That every one of us, we are justified by faith. Particularly, if you look at chapter 2, verse 16, chapter 2, verse 16 of Galatians summarizes the mindset. Yes. Good. That no flesh will be justified by anything else. Thank God for the leading so far in the Diocese of Ekiti-Oke. Because other places, alright, is structural things, alright, that we claim that we are doing the work of God. The question is, what is our justification when all things that is done in flesh for human to measure? And verse 17 of that same chapter 2 asks a question that I want every one of us in attempt to look at chapter 5 verse 16 that is our key before we go to the paper. He said, chapter 2 verse 17, what did he say? Yes. As a question, like I said, to be answered by every Christian. And when we want to answer that question, let's put in mind verse 20 that says, I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. Alright? And if we look at that verse 20, we see that we'll be able to evaluate what we do day by day. I've been crucified with Christ. I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. Excuse me, let's ask ourselves, is Christ living in us? If Christ is living in you, it will be seen in the life of your husband. It will be seen in the life of all your children without singling one out. You see, I no longer live, but the life I live in Christ. And the description of who Christ is, all right? He said, who surrender himself? Mama Bishop, I've asked of the king of my Lord will never die. As much as you two cannot die for Baba Bishop. So every one of us, we must single ourselves out to be able to say this verse 20 very well. Then it is there we know that we are running a race. And looking through chapter 13, I single out verse chapter 3, I single out verse 13. What is verse 13 saying? That is the hope that we have because we are being redeemed. Alright? Every child of God is a redeemed member. Alright? I'm not talking of, yes, we are a member of RCCG, but redeemed of Christ. And it is when you are redeemed of Christ. Mommy, Oyeka, verse 13. Yeah. Hey, my prayer is none of us should take course in Jesus' name. Because I always measure myself. Many a times we climb on the pulpit or we stand like this to talk to women like us. But the search warrant of self in us, we always leave it out. And do as I say, not do as I do. Alright? It's what is common, not only to women, even to men. But such sincerely will not honor God. Not only that one, the race we are running. I always tell my wife, yeah, I'm running my race. Run your own very well. Because he said, and if that is it, we must watch out on what we do every time. And he said, for the Christ that was hanged on the cross, for that sake, sincerely, all of us will get there in Jesus' name. Mm-hmm. And chapter 4 is summarizing the faith that we have in him. Alright? Justification by faith. Justification by works. So, by faith. And so many people, we want to measure what they have done. Excuse me, we build a big cathedral, and so what? Cathedral that is full with sinners. Cathedral that is nothing to show that a single soul is sincerely one for Christ. And as much as we have assessments, as a yardstick at times, we must be very careful. We must be very careful to know that the race we are running is beyond assessment payment. And it is then we'll be able to say, how then shall we be justified, if not by faith? But particularly, now I want to talk to this paper, particularly the topic given, how do we avoid the desires of the flesh? And it is where we want to sincerely give understanding, all right, to be in a modest form that we use flesh. The question, all right, the direct way of saying it, how do we avoid sin? How do we avoid sin? And I put here, seminar paper on avoiding the desires of the flesh on the 14th January 2022 at what do we call it? There's a name.
Diotrini Center.
Diotrini Center, right? What is the desires of the flesh? If you look at it, I listed some things there, right? So I will just read. To describe each and every one of these one is found in different men and women. We are running it like that one. Because this one, nobody can measure. You can't measure my own. But individually, we know where we belong here. Adultery, fornication, sorcery, uncleanness, idolatry, hatred, contention, to struggle, to emulate. I want to be. Excuse me, it's not possible for anybody to say all what I've just said within this few minutes, the way I've said it. It's either you add to it or you take away from it. Alright? So when you are emulating, emulate Christ first. It is Christ that will now see it. That what is good in that person you want to emulate, you will get it and get it right. Not only that one, jealousy and opposition with bitterness. Excuse me, I can oppose you, alright? But it's with clear mind. But opposition with bitterness. These are the things that is making us to now walk according to flesh. Uncontrollable anger. Mummies, uncontrollable anger. We must check it. Particularly the one from our blood. Alright? And the same woman that will now start kneeling down and begging God, please, because you don't know. You have said it in a negative way. Uncontrolling anger that leads to killing. Selfishness, ambition, resentment, and distinction of human inheritance. Envy of different forms. Thank God all of you look uniform and wonderful to the glory of God. Even I try to look uniform with my Bible. Right? It's your uniform. See? The uniformity must be seen in Christ. The uniformity of every human, not only men or women of the clergy house, but in everyone, it is then to be able to avoid the flesh, the desire that we have. More than call unlawful hurting. At the end of the logo, my fallen in, I became bad here. Come on, lay me. All this one, they are the things. All right, drunkenness. And too bad, the present situation that we find ourselves, in the name of, I want to look soon, I want to do this one, you hide and take a calling. Excuse me, all of them is drunkenness, is drinking habits, and the rest of them. Need not ready to give to the above. Until when we are, all right, we can now have our checklist. This one, you mark it wrong, it doesn't belong to me. This other one. When you have all these ones, that none of them is inside your life, then it means you are not walking, all right, to the flesh that we are talking about. And like I said, where it is where we want to polish it, we say self, as self, F-L-E-S-H, all right? For sin is sin, whether sin of the physical, sin of the spirit, sin of the, all right, they are all sin. So it is directly how to deal with self. Anytime, sorry, we are having convocation. All right, just watch it. You will know which professor is having self. Come back to the one. See, Agbe Popoyemi. The one that just have it. When they now say professor, the way they will walk is different from the way they are walking naturally. All right. So it means he has put on the garment of self. The Lord will help us to do away with self in Jesus' name.
Amen.
All what is listed above is self and sin. Now let's go back to our main text. Galatians chapter 5 verse 16. Galatians 5 16. Yes. Okay. This is directly saying that we must walk by the Spirit. I don't know if anybody can describe what is the Spirit. Alright? Like the way I'm looking at Sule, I know he put on up and down. And all the women here have white blouse. You know, that's the scripture. What is the description of Spirit? How we can describe Spirit is how you do things. Then I will know the Spirit that is working in you. Then you'll be able to know the Spirit that is working in me. Because if this one is not defined very well, we'll be deceiving ourselves. Or do all things before walking in the Spirit. That is, you correct. Thank you. They don't drink. Now, we are on the second paragraph. Flesh represents the sinful, endemic nature in men, in all men. That is to say, inertia, not be wasi, must we continue to be inertia? Not at all. The Bible says, God forbid. So, if we are to run away from this, then there are particular things that we need to see. Number one, what is in book, even in churches today, influences running after desires of this world. I was watching, what is it called? Not African Magic, but some of this program on the DSTV. And I saw in the section, there's time for comedians in the Church of God. And everybody were at that clap, alright? And what is it that they are saying? They are making mess of the word of God. Mess of the word of God. So it means even the people on the pulpits, alright, we are encouraging flesh in the church. Because all what we are saying, what we are trying to do is let it be popular. Especially with the young ones. And it's the young ones that are more in such places. Alright, because the old one, right, they are now looking at it, quarter two. Right? And don't forget what the Bible says.
Only any Toba Shekuni no one laughing at 800.
Alright? Isaiah chapter 65. Alright?
But this one, many of them with the enjoyment of this world, they are enjoying. 3 years, they are sufficient. Even to die after that one. That is the desires of the flesh. Let people know that I have money and I've reigned for just a short time to go. And I now said here, how much of the truth do we have? Verse 11 of chapter 3. The truth in you. A yasati e disky money. So we pay bags of a car. He said, first and foremost, look at the rich watch that you have. It must be a good rich watch. Because some of them were adjusted. That we look like the evening.
Okay.
That there's no truth in nearly everyone. So before the desires of the flesh will not be in us, we must be able to define the truth in us, which is the truth in Christ anyway. If the truth in Christ is not what is in you, sincerely, I said number one here, trust in God for all things, because the power of the flesh, alright? When you don't even want to see, alright? Surely we will surely see. No how. But I always put a question mark, alright? What I see, what I hear, how much of it will be ordained or sanctified by God? Number two, be contented with what you have. What you have, Oloma Buawa Alufa, last year so much. Alright? Very passionate. Alright? Women, I don't know, your heart is gospel. Another one will be contentment. If we can narrow such, it will help us and it will go a long way. Because things of the flesh is common everywhere, even to our dressing. This one is so beautiful. Hey, next time we want to have retreat. I will run and have it. Another retreat. And all of them. Me and my idea, I don't have this in you. So we must be careful. Because these things, alright, if the money is not there, power of daddy. You see, rice in the condo one, tomato tea one, just to get money for India. Number three. Should I say forgive me if I touch where I should be?
No.
Number three, be more and more deep in the love of Jesus. The love of Jesus is so much great that none of us should miss it. Alright? Jesus loved so much that he handed over himself, alright, for you and for me. And it is there you'll be able to run away. Number four, live by the leading of the Spirit. I tried to underscore, I threw a question and nobody has answered, or maybe when we come to question and answer, that let us try and describe what is the Spirit. For somebody to define what is Spirit. Right? So if we're able to do that one, we see that we are living by what we see, what we hear, and the digestion that we have from the inside. And that is where we are now going to say, daily walk with God, alright, like Enoch. There are some times I will read Bible, and when I finish reading it, I will be asking so many questions. Like when I read Genesis chapter 5, verse 23 and 24, the Bible describes the situation of this man, that he pleased God in such a way that God took him. When I say I take, the thing did not undergo suffering of any form. Genesis chapter 5, verse 23 and 24. Yes. And he not walk with God. Women, please let us walk with God. And it is when we walk with God, it will reflect in our husbands. Alright? Walk with your husband as Enoch walked with
in such a way that you're able to say, if my wife is there, sincerely, this is the area, this is what she will say. That is working with the first understanding of God. And it is not just one day. Alright? So we learn from the process. Yes, ma'am. Finish of 24. Yes? Yes. And God took him. Because God will take every one of us at the given time. Alright? Our prayer is let us pray that God make us to enjoy our old age, and I pray to be so in Jesus' name. I have a particular one that I come out from NIV. If anybody is having NIV there, alright, that is talking of your husband. And I want to send you to your husband, Malachi chapter 2, verse 5 and 6, which means the desires of the flesh, that I call Mr. Flesh. Malachi chapter 2, verse 5 and 6.
Okay, no NIV. Okay, read it
now. NIV.
NIV, mommy, yes. Yes. In the word it has been there, that's why I specifically choose NIV. Yes, ma'am. Malachi 2, 5 and 6.
My covenant was with him, a covenant of life and peace, and I gave them to him. This called for revenge, and he revealed him and stood in the way of my name.
Yes, mommy.
Malachi 2,
5
verses.
5
verses.
In the covenant, yes.
Of life and peace, I gave them to him for the fear wherewith he feared me and was afraid before my name.
It's God that is talking here. That is covenant with is with every one of us. I decided to give it to us. So the question is, how are you using the covenant that God has given to you? Alright? It's an agreement between you and God. Alright? And as it will come, which is your husband, then the children will now follow. Then, let us equally see 2 John chapter 6. Yes. 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 Good. That is obedience and love. Then, when you get to look at that one that is talking of walking in truth, walking in truth, without us, even say, save the truth. Initially, when it's coming up, you will start looking at mommy and daddy. And when mommy and daddy live in truth, the child will not have any other option. God created all our bodies. Alright, that description. Olubowale, sorry, I don't want to use both language. Alright? Ibi awọn obinrin o sumo tite yin obinrin o yo jade meji na o yo jade in God design. I told a church when oye pe eto o tole so pe me dash to kill. Yes, but obinrin to ba ma fun omo lona ti la se o agbubi lona. So it means you must carry more than the ordinary person, and the understood it. And that is why we want to talk about three organs of a system. Alright? These are very, very important. Tabale control method that is sincerely the desires of flesh will not come into us. What is the first one? Is the eye. You are producing and creating. Alright? The second one is the ear. And the third one is the one these and these now supply, which is the heart. And that is why everything, alright, that is the manufacturing engine in human, right? If a Latin tunnel all around, which is you give me. Alright? Etymology, Bosheki, then we interpret to what he had, not thinking of what the person is having, but he starts looking, alright, what he has seen, alright, and what he has had. We now give a negative interpretation of what he has. Now let's go to that one. I said, we will surely look at bringing human organs that we feel is much important to how a man will avoid the desires of the heart. Our eyes, ear, and heart. To be able to answer this, we want to look at 4 W. What is the first W?
What?
The second one? Who?
Where?
When? Alright? And the last one is the English. Alright? That will combine all these 4 W's. Which is how? How do you interpret it? Who gave you the interpretation? Where did he give you the interpretation? Is he at Oshi or at Oshi or at Oye or Ekwe? So, we now look at the meaning of salt. So, we started with saying, number one, the heart. Heart, let the word of God dwell richly in my heart. Can a man choose what he sees? Can we choose what we see?
No.
Not until when you can select. Right? Because if I don't want to see all of you, sincerely I will not come out from this place. Right? Even to invite you, right? Mama called you to come out. But we need to open our eyes to see. Number two, ear. And number three, heart. But let's start with the eyes. Numbers chapter 15, verse 39. My dear sisters and mothers in Christ. This is where you need to pick your Bible and write something where you put those thoughts, because we are going to identify some things here. Numbers chapter 15, verse 39. And what I want us to do, sorry, ma'am, what I want us to do is identify is it what, is it who, is it where, so that we have a good description. A good description. So if I see you, alright, sleeping, because we are going to the practical class now, alright? So we say, auntie, oh yeah. Numbers 15:39.
And it shall be unto you for a friend, that he may look upon it, and remember all the commandments of the Lord, and do them, and that he seek not after your own heart, and your own eyes, after which ye use.
Good. Now, is it who, what, or how that we have them? Because it is very important we understand it so that we know, we see the description of what we said here. Numbers 15:39. Yes? Numbers 15:39. Is it what, where, when, alright, or how?
When.
Okay? Who is saying when? I don't want for us answer. Who is saying when? Oh. Yes. Mama. I should know. When. Okay? That is to say, it's when. And when is that when? It's now. Eh? 14th. January is the when, so there will be a turnaround in our life after today's result. Job chapter 3 verse 1. Job 3:1. This man, he always say, yes, God sincerely tries me. But there's something I want us to see in the life of Job here, so that we know, even when it is not easy. Job 3:1. Yes, same opposite.
I have particular voice. Job 3:1.
After this, open Job's mouth and found his truth.
Okay. So, is it when or how or where?
How.
Alright. It can be more than one or two if you can say. Good. How and where? Alright? Then, let's look at Psalm number 121, verse 1. 1, 2, go. Psalm 121, verse 1. That one alone, man, answers so many. In that Psalm 121, verse 1.
Let's apportion it. Is it when or how? You see, we have so many. Let's start with the first one. Is it you? No, you see, you okay. So who is the first one? That is who. Alright? When is it? Is it not? Where? Is it for the day? So, and we have. Who is me? Amen. You will do me see. Now let's go ahead. The covenant not to sin. That's the first one. The covenant not to sin. I told you there's temptation every hour, every second for one to sin. Alright? But we should try to make covenant not to sin. Psalm 101 verse 6. Yes? Can we see similarity with Psalm 121 verse 1? Are there anything like? So, amen. You know, do me. Is he not one of it? The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Revelation 7:17. Revelation 7:17.
For the Lamb which is in the midst of the throne shall fare them, and shall lead them unto living fountain of water.
Good.
And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes.
Yes. So we can see, alright, the description of who has been in torment, has been in trouble. There's a promise there. Jeremiah chapter 24, verse 6. Those of us that have prayer, we can open so that we save time. Jeremiah 24, verse 6. These are the promises for those ones that live outside sin. And these are promises that God has given us. I said Jeremiah chapter 24, verse 6. To see for a proof. 1 Kings chapter 10, verse 7. Then we now see one more promise for what we read in 1 Kings chapter 10, verse 7, in 1 Peter chapter 3. Because it's side by side. In fact, I'm going to question time, answer time now. Mose, I told you about Bashir. How this? First thing, chapter 10, verse 7.
And the elements are met to fervent peace.
Good. 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 6. Ojo Oluwa shekin no. You see your back? Alright? The eyes of the Lord are upon thee. Good. That is where the word I want us to use. On the righteous ones. So it means if you are not righteous, Ojo Oluwa is not righteous. If she is not righteous, excuse me, it will be a lonely night. I will be going with my righteousness. But God forbid, because we are building ourselves, right? Together. And the Lord will help every one of us in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
So, eyes of the very old Jew that we are describing. God has eyes of, as we do. His own eye is sharper than our own. He saw beyond. So, your eyes too should work like that of God. That's a summary of what I want to pick out from us. Number two, here, alright? You might be saying, so you must watch, alright? See what we hear. And we have a prison, family prison. Whatever will not edify me, my wife will never tell me. Whatever will not edify her in this group, I will not mention it. Describe it anyhow, alright? If it over to solve Latin and drop, to be table. But what will make us to move forward, to share it? And that's part of how to live, to avoid sin, desires of the heart. See what I said about here. How do you control what you hear? To it and tell your bass, listen, to it give me loud though, alright? But there is a way they can be beaten drunk and somebody will still be comfortable to sleep. It means the person has chosen not to hear. So there are some things that when you are hearing the story and it's not a good story, just allow it to be. Let me give you the scripture. Show it possible. And you buy your sorrow. Say anything for what happened. Don't you buy it? But you are saying something, alright? It means the person has switched off. You don't want to hear. What you are saying is not useful. Alright? It's useless. Alright? There are times Christians must be able to cultivate this habit. When you are able to identify what is not going to make you to grow in faith. And I'm sure if our mothers will do this work, it will help us men. What does that have to do with this? See what we bring through. Alright? And that's it. When we go to a conference, there will be different people there. Alright? It's not a dry sinner that went to the water, came out as a wet sinner. No, there must be changes. And if we agree that, it will help us. So, let's talk about hearing. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 3. Yes. You now have faith. If it is a gift that you want from, glory be to God. You have faith. No matter the case, you click on the middle ones. So you will get to me. I can walk, I always say, when I'm in school, my public service, I can walk with anybody. You know that all what it takes me is to understand it. I will give you what you want. But when there is truth, it should be truth. I will not hide from it. I will say it. Say whatever. Alright? So, the ear, right? It's your man, you know? They must have a look at your nose. I think I can tell Arawa Segi. Amen? Right? So we must be able to see what we want to hear. And if what they are saying, to see there is power to be sincerely seal up. Close the chapter. Alright? From it. Somebody said there is a match, there is a, an understanding, there is something that can identify you. Even when the madman is talking, it's not give you the spirit of God for you to select what is good. And the madman, man is saying, madman, by this or by this, but dressing them. Dressing are not to say, but what to do, but what he's saying is so useful. Job chapter 43, verse 5. 42, verse 5. Good. Alright? When you hear and you hear what is good, and we are able to run, sincerely there will be period. That very in your come. Alright? That's why the Bible says it is good, alright, for two to thank. Alright? Because it says, one, we conquer 1,000. Two, we conquer 10,000. Raise your one to five. Which one is better? So the Lord will help us through in Jesus' name. Psalm 34, verse 15. Yes. Good. And for being here is useful for the first and the second, eye and ear. So prayers. But if it is the prayer of the simple ones, sincerely, God will not be here at all. You should pray, you're shaping. Alright? And here I see that seat, I want to do. No, just a few words. But for 3-4 days, 1 week, we gather together to be praying. But we don't have sincere heart. And we I want to come here. The number say, yeah, I want to come. Excuse me. When you pray such prayer, right? God is in you. The generous knowing you that is part of what we have. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. For God hears. Right? 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 12. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Right? The Bible is talking about sacrifice. It's good. Alright? Although you know what Sunday is going to be doing, but then while you're busy, we will go there, and then we go there. But come into account. Alright? For it. Ask me for it. We are going to go back to know what we present to Clergy. Alright? So we are back for it. So we must be able to be proud in what we need. What we don't do. That's in that Proverbs 21 verse 3. God will do something, alright? If God not close eyes and us as he does in Jesus. But let us live in righteousness and it will be there in the word of God. Name is Abu, memory woman shall better record. So no matter how difficult the situation is, I'll be done. Alright? So be sincere in all things that heart, which is the last one. They let their word, it should be their word, not they. THY. Let their word always very richly in my heart. Because Tobago Junior coming, and it is not well digested in my heart. Sincerely, it will not take anyone longer. So the first one is, where does these two things, the messages that we hear, alright? We hear with our ears, and the one we see with our eyes, where will it develop? So that the case is open, Ofe Shea Oki, Akama. Right? Oni Abadu, Olobi, they are separate. If the two of them did not come into the energy, will you ever get Akama? You have heard, alright? You have seen, alright? So we must now go into the heart. So how do we generate? How does it develop? How does it mix together? Before he can edify us. Deuteronomy 6:6.
And this word which I command thee this day shall be thy heart.
Good. So all the commandment of God that God is, has been giving to you before now, and the one that he has given you in this retreat, and the one that he will continue to give you, let it dwell richly in your heart, and it is there. Colossians 3:1 to follow. Colossians 3:1. You see, where Christ is, things always work. Alright? Not very easy with human, but when you depend on him, the result will just come out. And one of the guys walked with, he said, put me in the desert. If God is saying I should go there, sincerely, the significance of being in the desert must be seen. Alright? To be many at times, I walk over from very dead to posting. For God, the always gave me, we surely gave me, it's a passage. He just turned into prayer. I said, Father, no say, God, I'm not Muslim. He be too over, not even man. So God will make the way for us. Colossians 3:1. Good. Is that not instructive? Is that Deuteronomy chapter 10 verse 16? is there in the paper. Alright? So after this conference, alright, a guy of our student, that you mentioned, your Lord, without us in our time, was able to move forward. Right? The same thing he told me in 11:18. How does it come to us? Through our ears. Alright? He now said we should position it where? On our hands.
Right?
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. I was thinking we want to identify. Alright? When or yes, the students are speaking. The first time you do it, your kids. Alright? Oh, yeah,
because
I've
been here
to see. Hallelujah. What is the definition? And we made a mistake of doing handbands. Handbands. And we wrote for you to Kenya. The thing nearly cost us. Because both the old and the young want to have it. Only as a fact, when you go, you tell back better. Because you want to identify. Why am I saying that one? Once can they identify your unity? Every member of the church, even indigenous, by proxy, through marriage, want to have it. Everybody, the one, many a times, Christians are always afraid to be identified. We are lucky at this side. Right? I want to come and look for you. Right? Only you hear what the leaders in Mambu, you don't just say, hallelujah, in the leaders, so, cowards of the carelessly, you be. But still, you stand in the face of trials. That's what we are saying. Identify with the Lord at all times. Let's go ahead. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 17. Yes. And it's mainly a controversial show matter. Because some of the Christian what we have in our heart. Baba can solve it better. Ah, we don't know if we are going for what. He knows that we are better. She, Utabashi, Genegete, Abambe. Because at times you say, what is good money? Excuse me, what is where your heart is Genegete. So, the qualification for you to be a Christian will be measured from your inside. And nobody can see my inside. Then what can you identify what is my inside now? So it is only you that know what is your inside. And whatever is your inside is what we show off in the natural that you are. Now let's look at Hebrews chapter 3, verse 8. Yes. Anymore, at times, if you are not a Christian, alright, since you are all Amayans, what some of your women will do? See, you think God will ask you to be happy. Okay, but you must be humble enough to know that is their level. For you to bring them up, alright, your heart must be softened. Because if your heart is not soft, how does it mean to be aware of what I will have to do? When I be sure, I will be your one before I get to your father. People can make that comment. When the difficulty they are facing is not with the man of God, but with the woman of God. They want the man of God. So we must be something in heart to carry everybody along. In parallel with that one, Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 11. Yes. No matter how your superior wants to make it difficult with you, if you are standing with the Lord, you will be exonerated. But when your standing is not equally defined, sincerely, I think you'll ask. Alright? That is why some of our members, we share in this in so you could see, you know, usually in the fire and you get church. Man of God, who converted to seeking your mind. Because your standing is not. If I'm standing with the Lord, it's not only I know who I'm standing in. So we should not be deceived. That is summary of it. Isaiah chapter 29, verse 13. Let's do that this competition where process is going on. But if your heart is not there, there will be no reward. I pray, I hope we not be like that in Jesus' name. Parallel with that one, James chapter 4, verse 8. All the places I refer to here, both the eye and the ear, right? Those organs are referred to. That's why James is saying, I think it's not that you assume or you arrange that all of me, But if it is more than that, it should point you to like your own, but not of the heart. When you talk about it, it's actually, women, they are wonderful, they are beautiful, they are doing this one. But God is saying, let them know. What is the reference in their heart? In the reference in your heart, I'm trying to address here. The last one is Acts of Apostles, chapter 15, verse 3. We compare it with Philippians chapter 4, verse 7. Right? Yes. Yes. At the end of the whole story, we came back, we gathered together and worshiped God. For what God has done? Because we have seen changes. So after this retreat, I beg you in the name of Jesus, let there be a perfect change.
Amen.
From the heart, to the church. Then, we see where she said, till it reflects in individual churches. And sincerely, we see within a short time, the diocese is changing. I want your word of how I will be back. Please change. Surely there, not yet. Surely there, surely there, also. Surely there, in different places. Then, please, we are moving. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Philippians chapter 4, verse 7. They always go together. Ọlọ́run ni jẹ́ kẹ́ni kẹ́ni ní èrò bí o. Ẹni tó bá ní èrò iṣẹ́ kankan Ọlọ́run máa mọ̀. Àbí ẹ̀rọ pé kò mọ́. And the one that is
having more
Olùmọ̀ràn. The Lord will help you. In conclusion, I put here, your choice and behavior is made up of what we hear, what we see, and the totality of your thinking. The thinking in your heart. Else, choose to avoid whatever will not help you to make yourself a difference. Thank you very much.